esportsbets.com, a unique place for true gamers. The only place to bet on esports events. You know your way around a competitive gaming scene and are willing to take a risk? Watch regular broadcasts and earn real money. esportsbets.com. Foresight, passion, and calculation.
All right, welcome back everyone to the SLTV Starseries Grand Finals here. It's, well, not Grand Finals time, but we're at the finals anyway. Fnatic and myXMG playing it up, and we've made our way to the second map with Fnatic already winning the first one. So welcome back to the show, everybody, and remember, you're at Room on Fire. Go and follow the channel if you haven't already, and a big thanks to everyone who subscribed. Really do appreciate that a whole lot. Semler and Vendetta, that Dust 2 map, I mean, I think it went kind of like we expected with Fnatic winning, but Vendetta, you brought up an important point, I think, is that myXMG didn't really make a lot of really sort of horrible mistakes. Like, we sometimes see when teams lose, they end up losing because they have no idea what they're doing and that they seem completely clueless on the map. And I don't think we can really say that on myXMG, can we?
No, if anything, the biggest mistake that was made all game was Flush's interesting decision to actually face PNX. And, or was it Tenski in the 1v1? That was probably the biggest mistake of the game. I don't think XMG did a lot of things wrong, but they were just really unfortunate to not get the right rounds when they needed them the most. Because they could have broken Fnatic's economy quite a few times, and if they do that, they string a couple of rounds together, they build up an economy, they get a ton more buy rounds, and from there on out, they're impossible, or, you know, their possibility to get more rounds and actually get into the game increases intensely.
I think that what you just said there is, like, get into the game is, like, the key point of that entire first map, is that Fnatic just constantly won the rounds and denied XMG entry. Like, they just constantly won the rounds that would have allowed XMG to get any kind of money going and any kind of pressure. So Fnatic always had the guns, and XMG, well, practically every other round had the eco, and when you're doing that on T side, it's not going to be a fun time.
Yeah, and one thing I actually really liked about what Fnatic did, and one of the things why I'm a big fan of aggressive CT play, is when you do something similar to what Fnatic did in the first real buy round that myXMG had, which was pushing two people up in mid while having Olafmeister with the AWP spotting up towards through double doors, is the fact that if that round's successful for Fnatic, myXMG have to be so worried about aggression coming out from Fnatic in any given buy round from that point on. And that's big, because oftentimes you want to get into the round pretty early on Dust 2, unless you're a team like Na'Vi, right? You want to get quickly out to long, see if you can pick that guy off coming around the corner. You want to see if you can perhaps pick one guy off by double doors so you can get an easy entry towards B, that type of thing. And they get kind of put on a back foot, and they have to remain that way the entire game because, as Semler pointed out, they had to pretty much eco every other round. So your buy rounds are worth so much more to you at that point. And if you have to play off the back foot and played scared, it's just extremely tough to get into things.
Hopefully this break that they've had going into Mirage as the second map means they are going to be able to shake off that map. I think pretty much every team in history has had that kind of experience that myXMG just had of never really being allowed onto the map and just losing pretty much all the critical rounds, and that's pretty much it. So, I mean, they do have a lot of experience. Hopefully they can step it back here. But, I mean, Fnatic, I think actually Fnatic used to be one of the best teams on the old Mirage, right?
Yeah, on the old Mirage, I'm not sure, but when this version of Mirage came out, before DreamHack Winter, right, and all the teams were starting to prac on it and get prepared, Fnatic were the team to beat on this version of Mirage. Now, I don't know if they're still up at that point. You know, maybe Olafmeister and Krims is, like, the boost that gets them back into a top, like, top three sort of position on this map. But Fnatic used to be the top dogs on this map. Like, you had teams like Titan that were closely studying what Fnatic were doing and still not being able to reproduce it. So Mirage is definitely not the map that XMG want to be playing Fnatic on in their second, when the winner bracket is on the line.
Yeah, I actually think it's a bit of a rarity because we haven't seen that much of Mirage as of late. We didn't see that much on or at Gamescom. I think it was the least played map together with Cash.
Three times?
Yeah, it was.
You're right.
And in this tournament, I think we have, well, arguably the three best Mirage teams in the world. I guess you could debate the fact that British Pro might be one of them, but Hellraisers, well. Na'Vi, and Fnatic are extremely good on Mirage.
Yeah, and that's, you know, that's going to make it even tougher for the Danish underdog team, who are here replacing Marsport, who couldn't make it to Kiev for the finals here, which is unfortunate. But the good news is myXMG are not going to be out of the tournament if they lose this. They're still going to just go to the lower bracket where they have to fight whoever loses between Hellraisers and Na'Vi. And obviously the winners of these two matches, which... yeah, we don't know who is yet, but they're going to be playing each other as well. And I think that matches today, right? I think the winners matches today as well.
Yes, it's later.
So we have two more best of threes coming up. It's actually going to be a pretty long day, potentially, which is great news. It's no better way to spend your weekend than watching Counter-Strike, right?
Damn straight. But it also, it doesn't finish too late. So, you know, you still have time to go out with your mates and everything, but be sure you're here because the schedule so far today is going to be, well, our second match here between Fnatic and XMG. Afterwards, we have Na'Vi versus Hellraisers at 14:30 CET, and at 18 CET, we will have the upper bracket final match to see who goes into the finals. So, already three best of threes and a pretty good schedule to go with it.
Yeah, not at all bad. Personally, I'm particularly excited for the Hellraisers Na'Vi match because I think that's gonna be such a crazy game because they're both CIS teams because they've in the past sort of stolen players from each other. I really wonder what's gonna happen.
Well, Na'Vi are gonna be already. We have the defending champs, Na'Vi, so there is that. But it's also home turf, you're right, for both teams, right? So last time, you know, you could have said, oh, well, Na'Vi were the home team and home turf advantage, right? That sort of thing. But that kind of cancels out when you're talking about Na'Vi and Hellraisers both playing at the same time on the stage. You know, who is the crowd going to go for? And there is usually quite a big crowd over at Star Series as well. I mean, it's a great venue. So you know, how is that going to play out in this best of three when bragging rights is pretty much on the line to be the top CIS team?
And that seems to be, you're right, that's a recurring theme for SLTV finals, is that whenever there's a foreign team and then a CIS team playing in the finals, there's always this conspiracy going on that maybe somehow the Russian casters are you know, tipping the CIS team into something, which is absurd because that doesn't seem to happen anywhere else, but it seems to always come up anyway that they have some sort of advantage. So if the finals ends up being Hellraisers Na'Vi, which I think it could well be, we'll have to see what happens then. We'll come up with like a new conspiracy theory in that case.
We're great at finding excuses for teams.
Oh yeah, no doubt.
As fans of teams, if your favorite team loses, there's always something that can explain why they lost that doesn't have to do with the other team being better.
Yeah, jet lag, mouse not working properly, all sorts of things, right? The casters being revealing what's happening. There's always something.
Yeah. Oh, but yeah, well, speaking on the topic of Na'Vi and Hellraisers, who do you guys have as the favorite going into that match? Or do you think that's completely unpredictable?
I have such a hard time betting against Na'Vi on LAN. But honestly, I think Hellraisers have more practice going into it with boot camping and everything. And I just think they're more motivated perhaps than Na'Vi are right now. It also feels like to me Na'Vi has been, I'm not just talking like online inconsistency, I just feel like they might have some issues in the team that are a little bit more grave. So and there's something that feels off about Na'Vi. So actually, for that reason, I think it's a little bit, I'd still put it like 55% in favor of Hellraisers or something. Like really, really small favor, but a little
really?
Bit. Yeah, I would.
Okay.
I was expecting you to go with Na'Vi regardless.
Yeah, I was too. You're turning your back on Guardian, Anders. What did he say to you at Gamescom?
I don't know. Well, I mean, I think if Na'Vi do win it, there's a really good chance it'll be Guardian dropping 30 or 40 kills in a game and just going completely ridiculous. But the knife round is now going on, guys, so welcome to the show. This is Room on Fire in the SLTV Star Series Finals here with Fnatic and myXMG. First game of the finals here, and whoever loses is going to go to the lower bracket. They won't be out. Fnatic's already won the first map. That was on Dust 2, and they did it quite convincingly. And they just managed to win the knife round as well in the 2-on-4, so that's a pretty good start for them. We're on Mirage, and welcome to the show, everybody. I'm Anders, with me is Semler and Vendetta, of course. And we're happy to bring you these games. It's going to be pretty much all day and tomorrow as well. We're going to keep going with even more games. So invite your friends. Remember to follow the channel if you haven't done already. And you can still actually, I think, participate in the Facebook raffle that's going on, can't you, Semler? I don't think it's been closed yet.
No, I think it's still going. Mm. Oh, usually it closes on Friday, but the thing is, you guys can still go ahead and click that link and give a like, because what happens is every week when we run the Case King of the Hill, we'll be doing another raffle off of that page. So one like gets you into like another, basically like another 8 giveaways that'll be happening throughout the next month and a half. So, you know, guys, you know, you hit that like button, you stand to gain a chance basically at like 8 raffles and some sick gear.
Yeah. And speaking of giveaways, actually, I think we should do this today. I think we should have one sub giveaway today and one tomorrow as well. And because it was also, because we actually got this item from Stony Maloney, who's already also given a knife. Stony's like some sort of hero, actually. But he did gift us this M4A1 Cyrex, which weirdly on the picture right here doesn't look like a Cyrex, but when you do this, it actually does. I don't know what's going on, Valve. Please, Gaven, help us out. But we're going to give this Cyrex away today. We'll probably do it towards the end of the day when more people have a chance to tune in because of the time zone stuff. But yeah, so one lucky subscriber is going to be able to win one of these. And then tomorrow, we'll find some more items to give away to you guys because you're doing such a great job and really do appreciate it. On this map, I mean, yeah, Fnatic probably favored to win it whatever way you put it. But I guess in terms of for myXMG, I mean, if they can net 5 or 6 rounds on the terrorist side and then have a decent start on the CT side, I wouldn't rule an upset completely out here. I wouldn't say that Fnatic just have outright won it already.
I think one of the big things that plays for myXMG's favor is the fact that they're... I don't think a lot of people knows how they play Mirage. Simply because they're a fairly new team. They haven't played Mirage all that much, really. So if they've had something saved, obviously I don't think they would have used everything they had versus Fnatic and the hitbox challenge, knowing that they're going to play Fnatic 3 days later. So yeah, they could have something up their sleeves. I guess that's remains to be seen, but that's what I'm hoping for at least. And if they can get off to a good start, if they win the pistol and don't lose the anti-eco, then yeah, there's definitely a chance for them to do something.
I think that's the main thing, mate, is that you got to worry about that anti-eco here, especially after Dust2 losing in the second round, how everything shaped up after that. You know, they're going to be going through that in their minds right now, XMG. How do we not lose it if we can pick up this first round of this map?
Well, it's going to be down to the test now, right? myXMG starting on the terrorist side, and they're actually going pretty aggressively towards the A-bomb site here, and right now it's just Olofmeister defending with the USPS, so in terms of timing, if they push before Fnatic realize what's going on, and they will eventually because JW is pushing up the middle, so if they push before that happens, it could work out really well.
Here we go, flashes and smokes going down onto this A site, and the rotation is going to have to be fairly quick here, but Fnatic are not in position to deal with this. Great smokes cutting up everything, and Hunden manages to get the plant really early here, but now it comes down to whether myXMG can hold, because Fnatic, 5 guys still alive here, and they're closing in from all angles.
JW, very cheeky play coming up all the way from behind, and will take down Tenski, and now myXMG are weirdly focusing not just on the main entrance to the bomb site, they're also trying to defend from behind, and that's not a good position for them to be in. Grenade is going to rain in, and Hunden is going to explode. Now Flusher runs down, takes down PNX, MSL and Kevin are left alone here. The bomb is far ticking, but it's already being defused, and there's a knife as well. MSL knifes JW, and he can't get back in time to actually save the bomb, so there it is. 1-0 for Fnatic, and a crazy, crazy pistol round.
I was actually watching JW that entire time, and what went on in those apartments, it's hard to describe. That was a lot of clips being wasted and jumping around pillars with knives up. That took forever. That was weird. I actually thought JW was coming out of that ahead.
But in the end, MSL prevails. I didn't get a chance to catch that. We're going to have to go back and look at the
demo. It was close, though. Flush almost got a knife of his own. There could have been 2 knives in one round, like the first round of the map. That would have been one hell of a way to start this. It's going to be a B-Rush, however, for this second round, and now we have to see if they can put this to good use here. Pronex already getting a kill with that P90, but Flush is alive on short, and he's going to try and keep them off this site.
Bomb is going to go down, so this is already a big success for myXMG. However, it turns out they didn't invest into any kind of armor, so right now they're doing really fine. They're going to be able to buy the next round. They would have been able anyway, but now they can buy even more, which is great news. Flusher with a little bit of land wall hack, just shooting through the wall and taking down Hunden. But great play either way from Fnatic. I'm a little bit sad that Pronex didn't get more done. I mean, he's sort of relaxing here, you can tell. But he actually had a P90 against four unarmored targets. I feel like we missed what could have been a great slaughter up here if he had had the timing right. So better luck next time, Pronex.
Well, it did allow Flush out to get the opportunity to show off a bit.
Seriously, so, two kills I guess through that's walls nice. There for Flush out.
Yeah. And that the first kill he had was with the last bullet of his M4, so it was just like a one tap behind the guy on Forest.
Yeah, you kind of wonder about Pronex's position with the Pro 90. It really comes down to like the perfect start. You have to tag everybody basically to get end punch, or you're just gonna get nailed with CZs and P250s that close. So, not this time, Pronex. Now it's gonna be myXMG trying to wrap in through a quick A play here. Two guys get cut down in connector, however, and Olafmeister has boxed PNX into A slope. PNX nowhere to go, and he's got the bomb as well. It's a slaughter, complete and utter slaughter. Fnatic just shut them out completely.
And actually, what they were trying to do this round wasn't... Again, it's not a bad idea for myXMG. They were putting two people up the connector. They had one guy boosted in through the window, then they had one guy coming A-ramp, and they had Kevin up in the hallways with the AWP. This would have been a very, very cool four-way crunch into the A-bomb site. Actually, I would really love to see that strand used more, because I think that could work out really well. But because they lost the entry frags, it meant that Fnatic had time to actually cover all four entrances. But that's definitely not a bad idea.
Yeah. Pretty much what you said. Nice ID, not the greatest of execution, and that's pretty much what it came down to.
They're going to try again for a standard A push this time with the smokes, just like they did in the pistol round, and this time again they only have pistols. They will open up with a kill on JW, and Molotov not going to prevent the bomb plant, so this is a really good start for myXMG. They're on the less favored side, so they can be alright with losing a couple of rounds early on here, but they do need to return it at some point. Crims will take down my MSL.
Krims is just spraying through. Olafmeister is there alive in CT still, but that sets it up for Krims to come in from connector and get the flank shot out there. There's still three guys alive here for myXMG, and they're all sitting in A pit area, however, so Fnatic, once they figure this out, they're just going to be able to box them off completely. Olafmeister is already on that bomb defusing. They haven't been able to stop him yet, and they finally land the shot that does it, and they're even going to try and get the knife. Flusha just barely makes it out alive, but it's not going to happen. Terrorists win, and everybody goes up with the bomb.
Did they all just stay in the bomb site to try and knife him? Every single person died? Alright, that's fantastic.
It makes it
3-1. Yeah, it's worth it.
Worth it for myXMG. And I think they actually caught Olafmeister while he had like 0.1 second left of his defuse. So they were cutting it close. And yeah, that was just a really good eco round for myXMG.
JW smoked off, standard smoke into the window room. Pronex with a really good headshot gets a second one as well, and more people are coming. So when they try and sort of re-peek, and you saw Tensky, they thought, all right, Pronex must be low. It's actually Flusher taking over, and Pronex going to go back in and pick up a triple, take down PNX. What a sick round from the Swedish captain here. That makes it very, very tough for myXMG. And again, kind of like a repeat on Dust 2, just when myXMG are at a spot where they could have forced an econ Fnatic. Fnatic just redoubled their efforts and make it even tougher. Kevin misses a shot, and Olafmeister's going to instantly take him down.
What's really nice about what Fnatic is doing, though, is the fact that they're pushing out two guys aggressive. It's not just... you got to like the aggression, but you see it sometimes from teams where it's like they'll push one guy out on short and then have like one guy watching window, right? But now Fnatic, the way that they're changing it up is putting two guys on short at least allows for a refrag if things go south for Fnatic, or it allows for them to just completely annihilate whoever comes around mid for myXMG. So... You gotta appreciate how aggressively they're playing Mirage CT right now. And this is actually a throwback to LGB. This is why we always love to watch them play Mirage, just the aggression on CT side.
Yeah, they do lose a man early on, and actually PNX will pick up a second kill. So this is a really, really good round for myXMG. They've taken two kills, picked up an EK, and then they're going to put the bomb down too. So this time, actually, the aggression backfires for Fnatic. It could have worked out differently, but we'll see. Olafmeister nearly gets caught by PNX as well, and now Hundum's going to come run for him. And that might have been a mistake. PNX is going to be alone, and they will take care of business anyway. Actually, if Olafmeister had gone down in the kitchen, that would have opened up a lot of possibilities for myXMG to hide and be really annoying. But again, there are some margins here, and Fnatic just always seem to end up on the right side, basically.
One big positive, though, compared to the Dust 2 game, is the fact that myXMG are getting a lot of bomb plants. They've gotten... four bombs down so far in the six rounds they played. So that's obviously a great sim for them, because that means that they don't have to eco all that often as they normally would have if they hadn't got the bomb plant down. So that gives them a better opportunity to swing this back in their favor. And they're also doing a pretty significant damage to Fnatic on every eco round. So if they're able to keep that up in their buy rounds as well, then they can potentially break Fnatic at some point in this game.
Oh, grenade into the apartments here. It's going to do good damage. And a second one to follow. Pronax with nothing but headshots. He is going to take down 1, 2, and 3. Goes for the quad kill as well. And MSL is almost dead. Pronax will pick it up. Now he's just one away from the ace here. PNX ready and waiting for him. Pronax, he can feel that ace coming. He wants it. Almost going to get it. 35 health. They should allow Pronax to get it. He's spraying through the wall here. Olofmeister might be able to deny it here, and that's just bad mannered. They should have definitely given that to Pronax. So a bit of a, you know, a weird round from myXMG. And actually, Fnatic tried for a boost early on to the slight ledge that's right here by the apartments. Yeah. That would have been great if that could have worked, but even without it, it worked just fine.
Well, you gotta like how Fnatic don't try and make something work, even if it doesn't work. Like, they probably say, like, they have like a 5-second window at the start where, okay, if it works, great. If not, we just give up on it and switch it up. One thing to say, though, is that they did give Pronax every chance to get that ace. But, okay, let's go ahead into the A apartment slaughter that's happening right now. PNX will hunt it down. Krims is actually going to get 2 kills, but this is a very good start here for myXMG on this eco.
Yeah, not at all bad, but this time, as you were pointing out earlier, Vendetta, this time there isn't a bomb plant, and there wasn't one last round either. So, that's, you know, you're right, it is really important. It's going to affect the number of buy rounds they have in this first half. Right now it's 7-1, and they will be able to buy anyway. That's fortunate.
Yeah, that's the round loss bonus coming into play right there for myXMG. And weirdly enough, myXMG have gotten a total of 2 kills in their buy rounds. And way more during their ecos. So I don't know what's going on to make that happen. If it's Fnatic getting careless or myXMG just hitting better with pistols, but they're doing a better job actually doing damage to Fnatic in their pistol eco rounds.
So another really good grenade connecting with Tensky and Kevin as they come into the bomb site, and Tensky will actually get the return frag through the smoke, so that's very good. They seem to be very good at taking this A bomb site, myXMG, but holding it is a different matter, and this time they do need to do it. They have the one-man advantage, and they're even really far spread out here. I like these post-part positions, Samler.
Yeah, very nicely done there by JW to get that nade into the back of the site. MSL spots out Flusha, who is in CT spawn. Flusha deciding to push onto the site proper and get the instant headshot. Picks off MSL, and now it's 3 guys left here for the T side. They have to come pushing through smoke at A pit. Olofmeister casually picking them off, and now Krims has just locked Hunden into the apartments. There's no way out. XMG can't get onto the site. So, Fnatic, once again, with a very clean retake at the end of it. You know, XMG are great at getting onto these sites, it seems, but once it comes down to holding it, Fnatic with the A retake, it's almost like watching, like, old Na'Vi on Mirage, where they were just so patient that they wouldn't put up a fight to begin. They were just so confident in their ability to retake a site that it wasn't a problem giving their opponents the site. It seems like we're seeing the same thing with Fnatic right now. It's like, XMG get onto the site, great, but then Fnatic are just so good about retaking it that it's not even a real problem for the Swedes.
No, they're going to go for it again, the Danish team here, and it's just one person defending. That's JW already picking up a kill, going down into shadows. They got to deal with him quick, but he picks up one more kill. He's going to go for the C-set, and it's a triple. One guy defending, essentially a one-man army here. It's going to be Hunden left alone. The bomb does go down again, but this time, I mean, if they couldn't defend the bomb site in a 4-on-5, how are they going to defend it in a 1-on-4? And Hunden won't. In fact, he's just going to relax. Looks like he's had a bit of a wild night out, just, you know, by the trash bin. The end there. 9-1. Tell me this, Vendetta. This time, or not this round, but the last one, they had plenty of time to get into positions once the bomb was down. Did they choose the wrong positions, or are Fnatic just that good?
No, it was just a really solid retake from Fnatic, and similar talked on that point already. They kind of look like Na'Vi of old on Mirage. The fact that they're perfectly fine with conceding the bomb site to the T's if they don't get any initial frags, they just give it up completely, and they know they have something to fall back on in their retakes.
Now it's a double up setup from the CT side, so it's almost like, you know, again, Fnatic are doing a good job of playing a sort of mental game on myXMG as well. So just when they've maybe got used to one thing, it gets switched up slightly and makes it even tougher for the Danes to get anything done here.
The Danes maybe counting on aggression up mid. Not sure there, but it does not work out for them. JW manages to get a cheeky peek at the top of mid at the beginning there and gets a good kill to start. Pronax is going to eat a nade, though. PNX just hunts him down, and PNX is about to walk right into Olafmeister, who goes for the shot but misses. And now myXMG actually have a man advantage going into this. They can go for the B side if they so choose, but they're not fully committing quite yet. The rotation has come out from Flush from Fnatic through CT over to B site. But now, I mean, myXMG, do they find the kill fast enough to allow them to get onto this site?
Oh, wouldn't that smoke? Well, sorry.
I wouldn't be too surprised, actually, if they want Hunden to actually create some attention. And as you can see, Flush is being taken out of position here because of Hunden.
Yeah, he got JW's attention, but not the way he wanted to. It still probably is worth it because they get into the bomb site clean and just are able to put the bomb down. Flush also missed a smoke that could have maybe held them back, but now it's a 3-on-3 retake from Fnatic, and they've been great at retaking the A bomb site. Let's see if they can do it at B2.
So far, things are going pretty well. Flusha manages to find one guy out in the open. JW doesn't have a whole lot of health, so this really comes down to Flusha taking these fights, and he is going to get caught out in the open. Nice bait and switch there between MSL and PNX, setting up for that frag. And now JW, he's only got 2 points of health. After not being able to spot one, he realizes he just doesn't have enough time on this clock to be able to get this defuse. One nice thing is that MSL has already worked his way over to the A site, and he will hunt JW down in the end. So no saving the AWP here for the Swede. And he's actually going to donate it to MSL. So myXMG, they win a round. They've got two on the board. But we can see it's a costly round for them. They still have a man with a Galil. And now, I mean, now we have to see, are they going to be able to actually put two rounds together here? That's the big task ahead of myXMG. Or are Fnatic just going to change up their defense once again and catch the Danes off guard?
Well, we'll find out here. They're going to boost up into the whorehouse. JW is here with the AWP, so he's going to be AWPing from a slightly different angle. And the myXMG are trying to play as carefully as they can. Flashbang does blind JW, but he's going to go for it again, and he takes down MSL. Just way too much confidence for JW, and he's actually going to be chased in here. So Hunden decides to punish him, and that's obviously a great move. Pronax up here. I think he's already actually revealed his position, and he's going to fall back, but he's alone at the bombsite. Backup's coming now with Flusher, though, and that's good rotation from Fnatic.
Hunden is actually boxed in here as well. Crims will find the kill from Connector. So that's one man picked off a short. Now we're into a 3-on-4. And Tensky putting shots through that smoke. Brave play there. Crims coming very close to getting him as well. Flush is still alive here. So they've really kind of cut myXMG up. You have myXMG trying to work their way through B-Apps, but Pronax is still alive and holding. And Kev is going to get spotted out. It's just myXMG getting picked off one at a time at this point. Fnatic from every angle, keeping everybody alive apart from JW, the initial frag.
Yeah, that is pretty accurate. And just a bit of theory crafting here. The score previously to this round was 9-2, and if they had strung two rounds together on myXMG and made it 9-4, then Fnatic would have very likely been ecoing, and we could have seen actually, you know, sort of 9-5, 9-6 finish even, and that would have been, you know, again, there are openings here for myXMG, even though it looks like it's, you know, they're just getting completely trashed, and in a way they are, but it's not without an opening, and they just, every time there is one, Fnatic shut it right in their face.
Yeah, and the freedom that JW has right now to run around, they're going to try and cut him off, and they do that. JW missing shots point blank with that AWP does not help things. But then Crims rolls in and headshots XMG through the wooden plank. He finds the headshot on PNX, and the last man alive, Hunden, in get right falls to him as well. Crims with the 4K. I mean, he gets the 4K, and it's an anti-eco, but still, very nice work there, keeping his cool and just picking off the Danes one at a time.
Not really much to say. I mean, this is just turning out really, really badly for my XMG. Almost, it seems even worse at this point than Dust 2. But I mean, I think it comes back to what we were saying earlier on. Fnatic is just a contender to be one of the best teams in the world, and my XMG got here on a bit of a wild card and need more land practice.
Well, they're certainly getting their practice in right now, because they couldn't have asked for a better opponent, I think.
Yeah, it's tough. It's a tough way to learn, but sometimes it's also the best way to learn. Hunden is going to go down. This round is over almost before it's even started, and JW was also flanking from T-Spawn. So now we're in the 15th round, and myXMG don't really have any money to buy, so 12-2, probably going to be 13-2.
It's looking very likely, barring what? Some Danish deegs.
Look at Fnatic. Triple op. They have no shame.
Pronex actually picking up it up as well. Yeah.
All of my CDB apps flush it into support, but look at JW's position, all the way pushed up top mid, manages to find the first pick on PNX. But there's still two ops out here, guys. You know, myXMG, they're like, okay, now JW is kind of in mid with an op, right? But they actually had two out of three ops just sitting in mid, waiting to pick off myXMG.
And the smoke does go down, so again, another bomb plant here, but they just don't, I mean, they have three deagles on myXMG, which is a very Danish thing, it seems, and Tenski's going to pick up one and two with the deagles, so that's not at all bad. Now it's back to a 3-on-3, MSL very nearly goes down, but Flusher, or, yeah, well, he's going to pick it up anyway.
They don't have any more HEs, but still, Crims is in a position to cover Flush as he tries to get on this bomb. JW is here point blank as well, and the final frags will come through. The fuse goes through, and Fnatic finish the half 13-2. MyXMG not getting nearly enough rounds here in this T half, basically. They needed a lot more than two. This next pistol round is going to be invaluable for them.
I still want to give MyXMG credit, though. Out of those 15 rounds, they got 8 bomb plants, which is actually quite a lot, which is why they were able to buy up so often as they did. So they got onto sites, and unfortunately for them, the Fnatic retakes were just a tad too good.
Yeah, that's what it comes down to, and the few openings they had, they weren't able to make the most of it. Once again, kind of a similar story as to what it was on Dust 2, but I don't know, I still think this team has some promise, but you know, I guess again, when you get pitted against one of the best teams in the world, it is kind of hard to step it up and shine a lot. Going into the second half, yeah, the pistol round's going to be pretty important, and even if they win it, it's hard to get too enthusiastic about myXMG chances here, but we'll have to find out. Just 15 seconds away, if you're just joining us, then a big welcome to the show. This is the SLTV Star Series Finals right here at Room on Fire. So thanks everyone for tuning in. Hopefully throughout the day, more and more people are going to join us. We do have another two best of three threes coming up. After this one, we do have Na'Vi playing Hellraisers, and then we also have the winner of this match versus the winner of the Na'Vi Hellraisers game. That's also today. So click the link at the bottom of the page. There's a Facebook raffle going on, and you can go and, well, win all sorts of cool stuff. So don't forget to do that either. But now, let's get ready for it.
Yeah, it's time to get it on. Let's see what Fnatic have in store for us. Are they just going to go for a straight YOLO? They are shaping up for it. They're getting bogged down, though. This isn't matchmaking, guys. You don't need to jump.
Yeah, I was going to say somebody jumped.
Somebody jumped, but they still get close over to the B apartments fairly early here. Fnatic MSL is looking towards underpass though for XMG, and JW, is he going to run right into him? Yes, he will. Already shooting, and JW finds the first headshot of this pistol round, and this is a calamity already for myXMG. Crims is going to hunt down PNX, and that is going to be a very quick frag for Fnatic.
Yeah, good return from Kevin. He's looking for one more here in the middle. Does spot out Olofmeister, and he's trying to do it, but they've already lost a bomb sign. He's actually going to get backstabbed from JW, who didn't have patience with that one-on-one duel. So now, well, Tenski, good headshot there. Second great headshot. Now it's a one-on-two, and he can technically do this. I mean, he already had a really good clutch on Dust 2 earlier. We'll see if he can do it once again here. He's found Pronax at least. He's out of bullets though, and he's going to go down. Pronax will drop him, and it's going to be 14-2.
Pronax was some really impressive play this map. In fact, sitting at 14-6, he's had a lot of big plays to help Fnatic get to this scoreline here, but 14-2 right now for Fnatic is just huge. It's insurmountable for MyXMG. This is the do-or-die round, basically, for them. They're forcing up double scouts, CZ, you know, P250s. Like, they're just basically buying whatever they can on MyXMG to see if they can put a stop to the Fnatic train right now.
I mean, that's what they need to do. Obviously, ecoing and making it 15-2 doesn't really make any sense, so I don't mind that they're going for it here. Pronax with the opening kill though, and JW, they actually jumped in front of him and he was spraying, so it's about as unfortunate as it can get. Hunden in the middle will take down Pronax, but this is still a long ways away.
Oh, and they're going to get the hunt down in kitchen as well. Tenski is picked off by Crims. That's a scout down, and now it is just Hunden alive. P250 in hand, 1 HE, this is what he's got, and he doesn't really get the job done. JW will find him. So Fnatic sitting on 15 rounds, and just with basically the dominant performance we expected to see from the runners-up of Gamescom. Like, they are really just setting up, warming up, and this is going to be a very tough Fnatic to beat in the winner match later on today.
It certainly seems like it. They're on good form right now, the Swedes, and we're going to find out soon, hopefully, if Na'Vi and Hellraisers are too. I mean, they had better be.
That's going to be one hell of a match, but I'm really looking forward now to the Fnatic, and well, Fnatic versus the winner of that match later on this afternoon. Tensky's going to push into A apartments, but Pronax is waiting for him and manages to pick him off the start, and it's just going to be the close-in here from IXMG. They have to get onto this site and put up a fight quick because they don't have much firepower on their side.
They really don't. 4-on-3, and it looks like this might actually finish 16-2, which would be even worse than on Dust 2, and that's unfortunate. Kevin smoking and actually running through the smoke, an interesting trick here. Not going to trick JW, though, and Hunden, he will be the last man standing for another second or two. 16-2. I mean, Fnatic showing what they're all about here.
Yeah, just terrific performance so far from Fnatic. This is everything we expected going into this tournament. Now, Crims is going to take a damage, but JW will find the final frag, and that's going to be it. Best of three closed 2-0 in Fnatic's favor with some very dominant scores. So they will play again later on today at 18 CET in the winner match of the upper bracket. What do you guys make of this so far? Let's hear your opinions.
I think we've actually sort of already gone through it, haven't we? A fair bit. I think it's just that the few options, the few openings that myXMG had, and they played well to get themselves those openings. It's not even that, but Fnatic's just a beast on a different level right now.
Fnatic are just a better team as of right now. I think we alluded to that earlier on in the cast as well. So, somewhat expected. Well, the last time around they played Mirage versus myXMG, they won 16-3, so I guess Fnatic have improved even a tiny more bit from the last time around. But yeah.
So, I mean, ultimately, I think we just need to say that this is a tough practice run for myXMG, and it's only going to get even tougher. They're now in the lower bracket, and they're going to be facing the losers of Hellraisers and Na'Vi. That game is coming up as our next game, but it will be a little while because this game, I think, finished earlier than maybe the scheduling was called for. So we do have, an hour and a half or maybe more than that break. I'll try and ask the SLTV admins. I don't think they're going to start the game early. That's generally not something you want to do in a tournament because that gets really confusing. So, guys, if you want to help us out and stay during the break, we really appreciate it. What you can do to help us is you can just put the channel on mobile quality for all I care and mute it, and we'll just be playing some ads in the break and all this music too. But if you stick around and watch ads, it helps us out. It's not fun at all, but it is a big help to the channel. So consider if you want to do it. If you don't want to do it, then you know I'd perfectly understand. In the meantime, guys, everyone should actually go and get something to drink and eat. I haven't had any kind of breakfast, so I don't know about you, Samurai, and that. Have you had anything to eat just
yet? It's lunchtime now, man.
It's lunchtime, right?
But that's the thing, guys. You know, the thing is, we'll be back in exactly 2 hours' time with our next best of three of the day, and that's going to be Na'Vi Hellraiser, so you don't want to miss that. But you've got a little bit of time to get your strength up for that match. That's what it's all about right now. Go get some food, maybe take a walk, soak in the sun if the sun is out, but we will be back in 2 hours' time.
Exactly right. See you later, guys.